Welcome back. It is the middle of the night, because it is always the middle of the night. Definitely need a better cockpit. Let me see why experimental rocket planes is not generating. Oh, because I completed an X-plane high. So apparently we have to make a version of this that is a jet. Oh, that's right. We simulated and realized we couldn't make 600 kilometers. But we can certainly send up a biological sample. Let's change it around. So the other thing that I need to do So this has depressingly low reliability if memory serves. Test flight says, yeah, its ending reliability is only 90%. Starting reliability is 78%. Second configuration of it at least has... Oh, no, the second configuration also has bad ending reliability. It's just not a very reliable engine. The XLR-41 is fine. It basically is identical reliability to the A4. Heard of stuttering? Yeah, it is the beginning of the stream. So what I could do is I could put a second stage on this, but it's so aerodynamically unstable that that just seems like a really bad idea. give it a shot. Let's see what happens, but my money's on this is a dumb idea. Interesting bug. Speaking of interesting bugs, that bug is still there. Okay. That's interesting. Burn time is 52 seconds. So I guess we'll overburn it slightly. So let's do that. That's cool. So much for the retros. Hopefully it's not too occluded. All right. Now, fair nodes 1.4, not a whole lot of height, and I think we want the, yeah, that node turned on too. Okay. So this needs to be 22.5 degrees. Oops. There, that looks about right. Yes. Okay. That's the wrong stage. I'm actually vaguely tempted to pull an Agathorn here and flip this interstage upside down. And keep it with us as a boat tail. The other issue, of course, is ullage, because we can't light it at burnout. Well, I mean, I guess if we're spinning really fast, we can try to do that. See how this works. Probably should have changed that texture. Oh well. Oh, I haven't been using the. I launched it from here last time rather than the Kerbal Constructs LC3. Oh well. much lower thrust to weight ratio. Okay, we need to spin up. Yeah, that's, I guess, fairly expected, because we were still at fairly high dynamic pressure. Too much drag, too little thrust. And by too little thrust, I mean 2.5 G's is insufficient. Which, that doesn't quite make sense, so maybe I wasn't doing this right. Oh, but right, because also the ullage is screwy because we were spinning a lot. Nope, I'm just not nailing my hot staging, am I? Oh, I know what I need to do. I need to make PVG do it. Second stage is igniting, it's just immediately, because it's not actually providing any forward acceleration until I decouple, under the influence of drag, immediately losing its propellant stability. Alright, so let us try to do the mech jib thing. Ascent guidance. So this is going to be hilarious. Let's try something silly like this, and we're going to also tell PVG to ignore everything and just fly a pitch program. Let's see if it will let us. I just have to manually spin up. This is a little too aggressive a pitch program. Well, maybe it wasn't. Spin up. Oh, that's interesting. Even with auto staging, it's not. Oh. No, it did actually do it correctly. It just immediately cut the throttle. Yes. Okay. The goal for this rocket is a downrange distance of 600 kilometers. And an apogee of 200 kilometers. It's a film return mission. We're sending a camera up into space, and down it comes. Let's see. So now I have to turn on the setting that I don't actually like in Mechjeb, which is. That. So now when autopilot deactivates because we're out of avionics, we won't actually kill the throttle. Here we go. Talk about precession. Talk about dynamic pressure-induced precession. Also, presumably, it's induced by varying thrust from the two engines. So, spoiler, we're gonna make our requirements and then we're probably gonna burn up on re-entry. Because we're gonna have an entry velocity of about 4 kilometers per second. Look at it go. Yeah, we're basically doubling, if not more so, the requirement. We're gonna go about 1300, 1400 kilometers downrange, and we went up to 400 kilometers rather than 200. Should both flame out at the same time because I added code to Real Fuels where you can right click on an engine and you'll see it defaults to as soon as one flames out, everything, all of its symmetry counterparts will flame out to support exactly that condition. Yes, that's with the precession. Oh, okay, so it's actually going to be closer to 1500 kilometers. Well, no, actually not that close. About 1440 probably, assuming we don't burn up. Okay, well, apparently we didn't burn up. That surprised me deeply. Okay, so this is an utterly ludicrous contraption, but it will do the job without requiring much in the way of new tech. Like, given how far in excess of requirements we are, I'll remake this just with steel tanks. Okay, so. Let's recolor it. And I'll leave it using those engines. Or actually, no, I won't because those engines are unreliable. Hey, why is it not? What's going on here? Why is... Oh. Duh, forgot I had that open. Okay. 1 minute and 4 seconds is a little bit of an overburn, I think. Yeah, it's a 20-second overburn. Okay. Yeah, I could really use something to make this stable. The problem is the camera is so unwieldy. Biosample would be fine. But the camera is quite unwieldy. Let's add the biosample. Doesn't hurt. I mean, it costs a bunch, but we're already. Like, we have room in the fairing. So, yes, let's try that. What I'd kind of actually like to do is put a chunk of lead ballast right here. As long as I could decouple it with the fairings. Which, I mean, technically, I guess I could just put some lead ballast up there. Now that I think about it. And that would help a lot with stability, and that would also lower the delta V. Which, I mean, it's fine. Like, we definitely have more delta V than we need. So, that's something to think about. All right, let's try this again. Switch to classic. Uh-oh. Oh yeah, it does do hot staging. Cool. Let's try something like that. Hey, Tyson. Thanks for joining up. All right, so we actually want to end by about 25 kilometers. Looks like. Oh, I did not spin up enough first. Probably something about like that. See how this works. Spin up time. That was weird. Oh, I know what's wrong. Classic ascent guidance strikes again. Probably it was that. Good settings for the rest of it, though. Here we go. Perfection. Now we're getting somewhere. Right, MacJeb auto stages all the things. Okay, let's see if this may or may not. This may or may not get enough downrange, but we're sure going real high. Yeah, looks like we will. Not by as much as I would like, but we will. For the amount of delta V we put in. This is going to get toasty. Although, presumably, less toasty than last time. It's about 400 meters per second less. Yeah, that's not bad at all. Not bad at all. All right. That's successful. Sure, let's go ahead and tool all the things because it's cheap. And last but not least, let us make the umbilical tower higher. Or nope, apparently that's our only option. All right. Oops. I forgot. I forgot to turn on the biological experiment. You're on. You're on. You need to get turned on. And you're on. Cool. let's duplicate, and I don't know whether I want to actually spend 20k funds. Probably not. In case I have to rush the next one. So I will have. Oh, right. This is the contract that I accepted. Not the film return thing. Okay, so it actually wants sounding payload. And yeah. All right, so I'm gonna edit this. Yeah, so no, Mr. Bond, what I was considering was whether to spend 20k on an upgrade point, which would leave me with 25k, which felt dangerous if I have to rush build the next one of these, given how expensive rush building is. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to put some sounding rocket payload in here. Given that the utilization is low, it'll be fine. So 47 seconds. We need to add 35 liters. 480, which, yeah, that sounds about right. Remove all tanks. Put 35 liters in here. Fill with this stuff. Yeah, and stop auto-staging it too. You're absolutely right. Yeah, so I guessed about it right. So this one is the one that doesn't have the sounding payload, and this is the one that does. And we're going to launch both of them at LC3, which is the historically correct bumper pad, where bumper whack was launched. All right, so we have a bunch of warping to do. Okay, we're going to edit this. I should point out that my yesterday and probably the day before as well, when I've been flying this, my Mach 1 wave drag area was about double what it should have been, because far was using the collider rather than the mesh to voxelize this cockpit, and the collider is kind of screwy on the cockpit. So it was claiming that my wave drag area was on the order of like 0.5 something meters, and it's actually 0.2 something meters. Square meters, not meters, square meters. Okay, so I need to. This is now upgraded, I believe, due to the fact that I opened it. This has potential upgrades. Oh, did I have to? Oh, I bet I had to unlock it. Somebody needs to write an upgrade manager for the VAB so you can unlock upgrades from there rather than having to bop all the way out to here. Yeah, right, that's what's going on. Gotta purchase it. Alright, and air launch level 2. Did I ever purchase air launch level 1? I guess you don't. This is the. We need to settle on whether you have to purchase things or not. It's. Kind of screwy. All right, now I can edit you. I did indeed. I did do that last night. I fixed the tail section. So now everything should line up correctly. As you can see. Okay. Now it says upgrades applied. Save the edits. Oh sweet, it didn't actually take it out of the thing. Okay. Anyway. Seems fine. Gonna save in case something gets screwy. Let's train some crew because we'll also do a flight. Let's do this insanity and see what happens. Okay, now we're in the correct place. Now we're at Launch Complex 3. Auto stage and stop at stage. One. Let's do this. We should get some records as well. And this is super, super overkill for this mission. Could do it on an actual ARB rather than. Got to spin up. See whether MechJep stops correctly. I'm gonna let MechJep stage all the things. Might as well, right? Like, there's no air up here. We want to be able to start taking pictures. Okay. Bye-bye fairing sides. Here we go. So that's running. That's running. All right. No. Sounding payload does not. We set a speed record. As far as I'm aware, it does not. Yeah, it does not. You have to reach 100 kilometers with the sample and the payload. Once you do that, that gets checked off, and then you just have to return home. Oh fun, I forgot we were still in autopilot, so that just stopped our spin. Okay, we still have electric charge. Here we come, back again. comes slamming into the atmosphere. Bit more residuals than last time. Oh, no, also we had the sounding payload, so we were a little bit heavier, so that also decreased our velocity a little bit. Go. Painless. Nice gentle return. Gonna slam into the water at about, what, 11 miles an hour? Come on. There we are. Got a bunch of data. Okay. Now we can do the last of these. Duplicate this as well. Give us enough science to get an upgrade all on its own. That's nice. Definitely investing a point now. And we'll do an X-Planes High. I guess actually we'll wait until we're ready to go. Wish you could set a default. Oh, I have the source code. I can fix that. I can fix that in KCT. Let you set a default launch site. Or set a default launch site for each launch pad you have. That would be really nice in the Kerbal Constructs integration. Okay. So, pad reconditions. We're mounting to the carrier. We'll fly an X-Planes High mission. We'll accept this. It pays a little better now because we waited. Almost did it without accepting. Sure, Dale. We'll let you fly. Okay. First time that's happened. I guess we're landing in Georgia. And this is why you'd actually do it in Edwards, in a dry lake. Whoops, I thought I. Like in flight, when this happened, they restarted the XLR11. I guess where else would they restart it, but okay. Well, I guess we can consider making the ignition failure for this a minor failure. Why is it getting hot? What is going on here? I guess flying, that's weird. That was pretty weird. think it's the decals that are overheating. That's ironic. We should probably just give the decals in like very, very high max temps. 'Cause But I guess then they could shield other things, so that doesn't work. Yeah, I know that one, no, Mr. Bond. It's and I need to add code to Real Fuels to support a stair step curve for throttling. But like, there's a difference between stopping and restarting like that, and you had an ignition failure, which did not actually permanently damage the engine. Those are super rare, so I was very interested to hear that they actually had an ignition failure that they could recover from. Okay. Coming in for a landing. Let's go full flaps. Flare. Flare some more. That will do. Whoa! What just happened? We were totally fine, and then we flipped. That is, I'm gonna revert on that, because we landed fine, but KSP wheels did a wheel thing. Yeah, we probably should have stuff set up so you could actually do that in Edwards, but oh, this time it worked. I guess I feel like, in fairness, I should probably just end the flight now, but like, whatever. Because like that really, it's like we hit a speed bump. Man, it's been so long since I did this in my last campaign that I kind of forgot the flight path I wanted. I think I want to get to about 20 kilometers and make a run up to about 600 meters per second and then go for a climb. It's only 15 kilometers. Yes, the actual answer is we want to stay at a fixed dynamic pressure to have enough stuff on the control surfaces. So okay, we're still not at a thrust to weight ratio of 1 yet. So we gotta burn off a little more fuel first. Okay, now let's go for the zoom. Go up to about 45 degrees. A heck of a climb. All right, 60 kilometers. Okay. Cockpit's getting hot, even though we're this high. Oh, hey, Maxwell. Yeah, I'm actually wrapping up for the night pretty soon. I gotta wake up earlier than usual tomorrow, so sorry to have missed you on Dev Chat, but hopefully tomorrow we can catch up. Yeah, CMAV's airplanes are slick as anything. Oops, that was right. That was dumb of me. All right, we've reached apogee. So now we need to put that mode on, put the brakes out, and try to hold this attitude as best as possible. And Max, thank you for the good word. Yeah, Thyssen said, like, I'm tired of like standard shiny metal airplanes. I need to paint something different. And yeah, then a couple nights ago, I went and painted it to look like the Douglas Skystreak, right down to it saying B558 on the nose. I have a soft spot for that because it's Navy rather than Air Force. Yeah, I'm super happy with how this came out. Like, it literally looks like something from a flight sim rather than from KSP. Like, it looks like something from Third Wire Strike Fighters or something. So now we want to stay above Mach 2 as long as possible, so I can get all the science. How far are we away? We're getting close, although my heading is off. And by close, I mean we're flying over it. So clearly we did not actually go far enough downrange. So I'll remember that for next time. Nope, we're going to drop under Mach 2 pretty soon. We're under Mach 2 now. Okay, let's come around. Yeah, Maximal, that is probably true. I forget what the max temperature of this cockpit is, but yeah, it's not super high. I mean, like, I could land on that runway, I guess, but I'll land at the shuttle landing facility. Or, no, I guess maybe I'll just land at the Space Center runway. Brakes are very effective. Yeah, I mean we can set those gauges however we want through CFG. I did add that support back in whenever it was that we introduced that. So, like, we actually do that in a few places. In, I think, RO and Deadly Reentry together. All right. Gear out. I mean, honestly, I think it's less percent in general, and more that we want to measure it in terms of number of degrees. So, like when you're within 100 Kelvin of max temperature, then you get the bars or something. Because, yeah, percent based is prone to all sorts of weird issues. Coming in a little bit hot. There we go. Okay. Yeah, if you click about on Twitch, I have a link to a repository that has all the craft files and the current state of my save game, and also a .ccan mod pack, so you can automatically install everything. With the exception of a couple mods that are not on ccan, but I have links there in the README of that repository. 101 days from a much faster and higher flight. We got some science. We did not get enough of it, but that's fine. And let's check all the contracts. Oh right, I forgot about the altitude records from the previous thing. Crewed altitude record of 40, 50, 60. Explains high. Sweet. That was a bunch. That was a bunch of science and a bunch of funds. We're up over 100,000 funds. That's great. $100 million. So on that glorious note, I'll catch you all later. Thanks for watching. Night.